ChipHeads, eh? Welcome to Season 2, Episode 7 of the ChipHeads ChipCast, brought to you by Canadian Tire, a century of making life in Canada better. On this week's whale tale of an episode, we will be sipping Mickeys, wearing toques, and wiping our dusty little serviettes all over the family Chesterfield, as we worship our way into the Great White North with a native bag of Old Dutch, all-dressed potato chips. So, without further ado, let's eat.
Potato chips, how my mouth just drips. Potato chips, how my mouth just drips. Crunch, crunch, I don't want no lunch. All I want is potato chips. Potato chips.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. As we said, Season 2, Episode 7, we got a big one for you right here, right now, this month, this year. A Canadian shipment has arrived over the border, across the way, to all the chipheads in the USA from a wonderful nation of Canada. So I want to know what's going on. There's a lot of texts on the chip thread over the last week or so. Let's kick it off with a whip around the chip. Okay, idiot, I want to go to you because you have a great name this week. Yeah. That's Dan. That's Dan on the ChipHeads ChipCast right here. Labeled himself idiot. Kind of want to know what you were thinking when you put that down there. And also, what has been going on in your life over the last few weeks?
Yeah, I was just trying to give myself an honest self-assessment, you know, and I just, that's the word that came to mind. And I thought, that fits. I'm a bit of an idiot. Last few weeks, I think the highlight of my last few weeks was a couple ChipHeads coming over to my house and sneaking around and doing a little bit of a chipment pickup. One David Miller and one Brady Dvorak came over to my home and we drank some alcohol. What did we do? I don't want to spoil anything, but we rocked out, ate some good food, and had a great time. That was probably the highlight of my week, month, year, life. Probably my life. It was probably the best moment of my entire idiot-filled life. but I'm fine, Steve. How are you?
Every time
I don't think you're supposed to use our first and last names.
At the house. At the chip factory there in Grainfield,
Indiana. Brady Allen Dvorak.
Yeah, wonderful. I'm really jealous. I couldn't attend. I did get some photos, though, and they were really sexy, I should say. I mean, there was peanut chips everywhere, boxes, bags. It looked really wild.
Your chipment was quite amazing. It was really impressive for the people listening, watching at home, the many dozens, hundreds, thousands. It was a very large box. Very well packaged.
I didn't expect that box to be that big.
It was packed big box. With the shipping peanuts or whatever. I mean, it was a huge box. And I had to keep preserving.
Five bags
we kept
each
it in our kitchen.
For the three of us.
Five bags each. We kept it in our kitchen so that everybody could see it. It's that box was just recycled on Tuesday. So RIP. But
you just kept
thank
the box because it was so big. It was just
With everything in there. I wanted them to see the display. Cause even the keep it chip at the very top was beautiful. Well done.
Oh,
well done,
glad
Steve.
You
how
like
are you?
That. Yeah, that's how we take care of each other here as fellow chipheads. And on chipheads.us, you can go ahead and sign up for a subscription as well. And we'll send you a box of peanut chips. They actually refer to them here up in Canada. Up Canada way. King Chip, that makes me think of you because you like to use the phrase up Canada way. How have you been over the last few weeks? You attended that chipinalia, but what else has been going on in your life? Looks like your hair got a little shorter.
I did. I know we like to talk about barbershops and all that stuff on this show, but I'll spare you guys and just give you the quick and dirty. I got the old choppa choppa.
Sport clips.
Otherwise, aside from that, and it was just sort of time, you know, you just got to kind of lighten up the head a little bit every once in a while. But aside from that, it's been great. I had a fantastic time over at Dan's Chipinalia. I've had several other Chipinalia. Throughout this week alone, it was almost sort of a day or week of celebrations. Old Miller, David Miller, grocery man over here, his birthday was on yesterday, Wednesday, I believe, which was fantastic. Very exciting. Congrats, David. That's a pretty big achievement. However old you are, that's important. The day before that was V-Day, which is sort of victory day for me because
for love.
Well,
for
a couple things happened. I got a Valentine's Day card for my mom, which was nice. And then after that went, took some of the girls down to the the old Freemason Grand Lodge there on Main, and a local priest who,
which girl,
a Catholic priest,
yeah, who?
Who's also local Catholic priest. He didn't really stay for the whole sort of thing, but he's also secretly a Freemason, so he lets us into the basement. That's where I had my initiation ritual and everything. But
what's his
dream
name?
Come true. Went down and did one of my favorite Chipinalia variations, which is where we take chips, crunch them up, put them in our underpants, and then sweatpants over the underpants. So it's skin to chip, and just dance for about 3 hours, maybe a little more than dancing. But it was a fantastic, fun day, and it was just a couple chips girls from the local bowl, not the whole crew or anything. So it was a blast. I'm still kind of reeling from a lot of
chafing?
Different stuff this week.
Do you get
week.
Chafing from the chips?
But
the
chip reeling, dealing, and I'm here with you guys and happy to be here. So
no.
What's shaking, big pun?
Can you hear us? Am I?
Don't come to me after that. I don't want to follow up that.
Yeah, Brady, was there chafing? Was there chip chafing or no?
He's gone.
Yeah, he's gone. He's still, I don't know.
He's getting chafed. He's creaming his chafes.
Yeah,
I'm here.
He's putting some chafe cream all over his body right now. We'll let you take care of that, King Chip. And why don't we go on over to birthday boy himself, Old Mill Dog, Davo. I wanted you to go last, but Big Pun apparently has a big announcement to give us. Also, Old Mill Dave, happy birthday.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, you know, it's so good to see you, and it's always a big week for you, because I remember, you know, it's Valentine's Day,
mm-hmm.
it was your anniversary with your wife before you got married, because it's like when you guys first started dating, and then also your birthday, just amazing. How are you? How did you celebrate?
That pretty much captures it all. You know, February, mid-February is a busy week for me, always cold in the Midwest, it's sleeting, snowing, raining right now, but birthday was great. We were going to go out, but both busy with work. We had sushi delivered, and it was a great
nice.
Sushi restaurant, Q Sushi or something like that.
Nice.
So just got a nigiri platter. Fantastic. Loved it.
Talk to me.
Saw 50% of the other four chip heads this past weekend. We saw both families as well.
Wow.
Love Dan's house. Guys, Dan has been slapping the bass. Dan turned me on to a song I knew about but did not know about and have listened to maybe 500 to 600
Bare Naked Ladies?
Close. Don't Let Me Down by the Beatles.
Fair enough.
Great track. The Bare Naked Ladies of the 60s. That's what I would say.
Yeah.
That's what everyone says.
But
you didn't know about the Beatles before Dan introduced you to them?
No, well, in particular, that song. That song has just really...
It's a hot track.
More of an Eric Clapton guy myself. But.
Got some Barnabys, too, hand. And was sent home with some Barnabys.
Unplugged.
And then having Barnabys, like, maybe 4 days in a row.
Oh, yeah. My gosh. So jealous.
That's good 4 days.
Yeah, well, we can't let you off there, because there was a special birthday message that was sent to you that I'd like to play right now. And I'm hoping you could explain for our viewers where this message came from. So let's go ahead and cue that up.
This is actually the best part.
From my house to yours, my friend, I didn't want this day to go by. It was a crazy day. However, wanted to wish you a happy birthday. But notice also, you didn't respond to my happy birthday, what it looks like from last year. So I hope this is still your cell phone. If you're still in Chicago or wherever you are, respond to me, please.
Okay,
where are you,
Dave-o?
David?
Who was that special someone, and why haven't you responded?
That is my realtor who we signed the lease from 4 years ago. Maybe I talked to him for maybe 2, 3, maybe 4 minutes. My wife was appalled that she has not gotten a birthday message. I saw it and I was like, this is a random video. I was like, this has to be a spam. I Googled video sent by random number. Ended up clicking on it. I was like, is this a realtor? And she's like, yeah, how come I've never gotten one? So I don't know. Dan made a good point as to what that could be. So I'm just going to go ahead and not reply to that.
I think you should call him back.
Did you see the previous message or?
No, I had deleted it in my phone because my phone's out of memory because so many photos of my son at this point. You know how that goes. But
yes, not, boy.
You know, yes, not boy. To. I listened to another podcast and they break down videos like that all the time. They call them cool guys. The cool guy club is somebody who would send a video like that to, you know, anybody else. So.
David, when you sent that, I was crying. I was literally weeping. I was laughing so hard. And then you sent that follow-up video. Like, I feel like I found my people. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. It's very much how I approach work. I'm like, please just respond to me or don't. I don't care. But I'm a big, strong guy, and I'm really good at fixing stuff, and I don't have any emotional issues, so don't, you don't have to tell me that you like me.
Well, any birthday message is a happily received birthday message. I received 4 from you all, and I had a great day. Pana, I'd like to hear more of what's happened in your life.
Quick. Look, bless you. I didn't want to go last because I have some big announcement. I just needed more time to regroup. Mm-hmm. I just needed more time to regroup. The only thing I can say is I'm completely shooken off my game right now. As I alluded to prior to hitting record on this. Do you know when somebody's insanely mad at you and yet you don't have any clue why?
Oh yeah.
But then that person turns out to be your boss, and they were just yelling at you 10 minutes before your podcast. That's what happened to me. I have no clue what I did to set her off, but that was a very awkward conversation, and I'm reeling right now. I'm a fish, Kevin, on a hook.
I need you to look me in the eyes right now, Kevin. You're a wonderful person. You're great. I needed you. Are great at what you do. You have an amazing chip tongue. Mm-hmm. You are great at picking sushi restaurants.
That's right.
You're a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful friend. Do not let her get you down. You will not. And do not get down in the dumps like I was last time. It's not worth it. It's just a job. You're better than this. Kev, you got to give fives to get fives. And I'm giving you a 5 right now. You're a 5 out of 5. And you're going to nail this. You're going to nail this episode. Okay? I love you.
I wish I could be right now. Sarcastic, but that was the greatest thing you could have ever done to lift me up right now. I'll give you a quick little peek into that horrible conversation.
Just give us a little tease.
A little tease. So she was calling me about one of our clients was doing something they shouldn't be doing, and basically I was getting yelled at for not running it up the chain to her, which I did immediately, so I had no clue what she was talking about. And then while she was mad about that, she was like, oh, and by the way, yesterday's tone. So we have like stand-up calls, you know, like your team gets together, and quick little 10-minute calls. I was asking her about something. She asked for more information. I gave the details that I had, and then she asked a follow-up, and with no disrespectful tone whatsoever, I said something along the lines of like, again, I think blah, 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 here's where we're at. And she was like, I didn't like when you said again, blah, blah, like I was disrespecting her. So yeah. So I almost started laughing. I was just like, yeah, I don't even know what you're talking about. And then she was like, don't worry, we're going to set up a one-on-one for tomorrow. We have things to cover. So at 11:30,
you were a 5 out of 5
Pacific tomorrow. 2:30 Eastern, your boy is going to be just getting dragged through the mud again. So I'm here. I'm excited. These all chips have been staring at me for a while.
There you go.
Big pun. I'm so sorry.
This is what I need. This is a pick.
We got Miller's birthday. We got the followed by Brady's birthday coming up. We got Steve's birthday coming up.
That's right.
And Valentine's Day. You can't be getting dragged through the mud.
That's right.
If don't you know, like the mud. I ain't no pig.
I'm getting dragged in the mud too. I'm in the mud. So come in the mud with the idiot and we'll have fun.
Sometimes the mud is fun.
You know, we'll go get some sushi.
Yeah,
we'll
enjoy the mud.
Steve, tell us about your life. How's your job?
You look so good, Steve. You were
well. I'm all dressed up for this week's episode. I know. Thank you for noticing, Dan. I got my Canada hat. I've got my little red sweater here tied around my shoulders. I'm all dressed up for this wonderful chip that we've got. I'll be swift. The last few weeks have been fun. Went to Scottsdale, Arizona with my lovely wife and daughter, and met up with some of my lovely wife's college friends who have gotten married and had kids. We had a nice little weekend in the 70-degree weather, went to a wine and art walk, hung at the pool at the house. It was nice. We had an in-home hibachi setup.
Tell me everything.
They're primarily on the Eastern Seaboard. I forget exactly what their name is. I should plug them here.
Haniori.
I'm looking for a business card. It's like a Haniori, but it comes to your house. And so these two dudes show up. They showed up about a half hour late. Because this guy who he thought his name was Tony, but he turned out his name was Carlos. He got pulled over by the police on his way over to the house. He was a little late, but it's good. We got the kids down. So they show up. They come into the backyard by the pool area. It's like a cabana where we're all sitting and hanging out. And they've got, you know, the hibachi grill tied up to some gas tanks and then super soakers full of sake. So this guy is just dicing up, putting on the full show. He's doing the onion volcano. He's calling people up to like flip eggs on spatulas.
Dude.
You know, he's making the big flame balls, what have you. And then the other gentleman was walking around with super soakers and just squirting sake into people's faces. And this went on for a solid 2 hours, and it was fantastic. So can't recommend it enough. Look up in-home hibachi. We came back. Whole family got sick, unfortunately. Franny's, you know, which is good. Good to expose her to some other children, I suppose, and, you know, the germs of existence. But, yeah, we're excited to be back. And as soon as I got back, Brady has been incessantly texting about this Canadian shipment and where is it? Where is it? We've been hearing so much about these Canadian ships. So went all over town. And what started off as maybe a 3-bag shipment for each of the chip heads turned into a 5-bag shipment really quickly. And so got that all packaged up and sent on over. And you know, looking forward to munching through it all. And we're going to start off here tonight with the Old Dutch All Dressed from Winnipeg, Manitoba. Danny.
Should we do a 2-bagger? We haven't done a 2-bagger since season one. Should we try a 2-bagger?
We should maybe consider it. I don't know if we'll have time for this episode because
No, I'm not ready.
I want to give the sour cream and green onion the next next bag its due. Let me walk through them and maybe we can take a poll. If you go to chipheads.us, you can vote on a 2-bagger potentially. The 5 that we have that were sent. The Old Dutch All Dressed, which you can see here, which we're reviewing today, which is very exciting. This is like an absolute standard. This is Canadian.
This might be Canada's the jewel of the shipment. This might be the jewel.
It very well could be. I'm excited for you all to try it. I've had these clearly. Then we have the Old Dutch Sour Cream and Onion. Fantastic chip. We have Hard Bite. That's a brand. Smoke and Sweet Spud. So those are like barbecue flavored sweet potato chips. Excited for that one. We have Covered Bridge. They're out of Waterville, New Brunswick. Sea Salt, straight up, straight classic. Had to put one in there. And then, and I should mention, Hard Bite is from Vancouver, Old Dutch from Winnipeg. And then the Neal Brothers Mexican Street Corn is a corn chip with some bomb flavor. They're out of Richmond Hill, Ontario. So I wanted to cover the full country.
I love it.
And get a little taste from a lot of the provinces here. Anyhow, looking ahead.
Yeah.
I'm doing very well.
I'm so pumped.
So good to see you all.
I'm so pumped. I'm so pumped that you're all dressed. I don't know if I should hold it for the weekly worship, and I may, but has everyone tried an all-dressed chip? I just recently had my first shout out. What? Hold on. I might be jumping 2 seconds
at once. Why don't we go ahead and do this?
So. Yeah. So I recently just tried my first all-dressed chip. Shout out Justin Carter. I think it's like his third shout out, maybe. Former colleague of mine. He sent me the shipment from Canada recently as well. It had Lay's All Dressed. And not going to lie to you, it might be the varietal that I've been looking for my entire life that I thought was the sweet and sassy, which could be, which is very similar. But I am very much looking forward to this All Dressed chip. I've never tasted one before. It was my first time having any All Dressed. And my Lord, it's beautiful. And
was
I
that
can't
a Lay's
to...
all dressed, Danny, or was it a Ruffles all dressed?
Just a Lay's all dressed.
Oh, straight Lay's all dressed. I haven't even seen the straight Lay's all dressed.
Delightful. It was delightful. You guys know we got the Lay's issues and stuff like that. This was good.
Had the Hard Bite all dressed. I've had Covered Bridge all dressed. I've had Old Dutch Ridgies all dressed. I've had Ruffles all dressed, and clearly Old Dutch Classic all dressed. I think that covers my. All dressed exposure. But King Chip, Big Pun, Old Miller, have you ever had this varietal before?
I've had a bunch of all dressed. I've had the Lay's.
Okay.
Old Dutch Ridgies. I don't think I've had Old Dutch non-Ridgies, but we're eating here tonight. But I have had them now because I've been munching on them for the past 30 minutes.
Good for you.
Steve, maybe you ought to tell our listeners at home what exactly all dressed even means.
That's a great question, and I will get to that. And why don't we just get to it right now? So the all-dressed origins, we're gonna play a game here. We're going to talk a little bit about Old Dutch, and let's just get right into the origins of all-dressed. They're actually, so technically, they are a mixture of other flavors that are very prevalent here in Canada. They include ketchup, barbecue, sour cream and onion, and salt and vinegar. All combined.
Love it.
And there might be some extra flavor. And we'll go over the ingredients here on the back and talk about some of the malic and citric acid, sodium acetate, spices, et cetera, what have you. But that's primarily what an all-dressed chip, is comprised of, which makes me think of the prison chip we did
That's what I was going to say. If you were to name two chips that we've had before, I think there's two that are somewhat close to this. I know the prison chips.
I was going to say the Zaps Voodoo.
And Zaps Voodoo,
With less crunch.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
I also feel like there's a little sweet and sassy in there. I'm serious. Like, it's that that barbecue ketchup-y thing that mm-hmm. added it. It's like a, if barbecue and SVO had a little baby, it would come out with this. Or something, or had a baby. It's beautiful.
If you guys aren't familiar with what the prison chips are, if you're new, the season two's new to you, go back to season one. It's called the whole shebang. Episode something.
Whole shebang.
That was when we were at our pinnacle. That was the peak. Yeah, we were in this. This phase of some things, and that was a good one. Yeah.
Right. For the record, those received an 81%.
Very good. Okay. So I mean, there's a precedent that's been set.
All time fave because it was just awesome. It was a fun.
Yeah. Wolf tickets.
Wolf tickets. That's right. And I should add, these were first produced by the Yum Yum Potato Chip Company in Quebec. In 1978. So this is when they first came to be, and this is on the East Coast, very French influence of Quebec. And speaking of history and facts, I'd like to play a little game, if you don't mind, in honor of Canada's most beloved native son and game show host, Alex Trebek. Let's play a game of Chipperty.
You got it.
Is Jeopardy.
Okay, let's fade that out.
R.I.P.
I love that. I could listen to it all day long. Alex Trebek, yes, R.I.P. from Canada. Shout out Alex Trebek. So, Brady, I'm glad that you already opened your bag, because I want all of the chipheads to open their bags right now. To buzz in, you actually have to crunch a chip into your microphone. That's how you buzz in. I'm going to be asking 10 questions. 10 questions.
Listen. All right, I'm opening mine.
Yeah, open that bag. Take a whiff. Yeah, exactly right. We're seeing some, some good colors here. We're seeing some. I'm going to go ahead and open mine as well, too. It's a new way of doing things. We actually, Canada.
David, you have to take that as your bite.
Oh, my God.
Can I try one yet? Because I think I think I need to get one out of the way, because I'm not going to answer.
Well, I want to be here for it, too. Yeah, exactly. I want to be here for that trial. So just so you know, everybody out there listening, King Chip Brady has disappeared from the cast right now. We're hoping he gets back, so we're just going to vamp for a little bit. Everybody's munching on chips for the first time.
This is my second all-dressed chip I've ever had.
Mm-hmm.
Lay's was good. This is different. This is next level. This is next level.
Okay, good. I'm glad that you're feeling things, that you're seeing things. Big pun taking it lightly there. Maybe just going for the dust crystals to kick things off. Nope, you're on mute. Can't hear you.
Good, because I've said 6 times in a row that I've been eating these like a monster already. I've had them. Look at this bag.
Oh, wow.
So I want to air one grievance.
Okay.
I really wanted to record this before the Super Bowl, because I really wanted to get down on these during the Super Bowl. And now that I'm trying them, I'm angrier at your travel plans, Kevin. I just need to say that to you as a friend.
It wasn't me.
5 out of 5.
That wasn't the holdup. The holdup was we needed to get the chips to Chicago.
You were out of was that it? I thought you were out of town this weekend.
Well, I was, but Damo didn't have the chips either.
True. I don't like your tone, Kev.
I'm starting.
Did you say again? Was that again?
Yeah.
Again. Did you say it wasn't again? Me. It was old Miller. I'm starting to hear it too, guys. I don't know. Maybe she's onto something.
I'm sorry. Knows. We need to circle back to see where we netted out on that again.
That's exactly right.
I hope I just can sleep tonight. The anxiety is just crippling
Dude,
right now.
Jobs suck. It's just.
No,
we should just do this for
hey, life. Shout out Octagon. The only time in the last 4 years I've wished I was back there.
All right, I'll have
my I had a sketch. That's right. I don't know what happened to Brady. I think we just get into it, Steve. Let's just do it.
Oh, my God.
These are amazing. Spoiler alert. Hashtag Brady, spoiler alert.
Did you hear the inside of my mouth on that one, Fun?
Yeah. Ripped open.
I wish it was in the inside of your mouth, Mr. Alldressed.
Brady says he's here.
No, he's not.
Was he in the wrong podcast again?
Wait, you guys can't hear me?
Should we just play the game?
Yeah, let's play it.
Okay, so to buzz in, you have to crunch a chip into your microphone. All right, so that's your buzzer. That's something new we're doing here. And let's go ahead and fill that board. Okay, we got 10 questions. Is everybody ready with a chip?
Yes.
No.
And this is not going to be traditional Jeopardy format because we do things a little differently here in Canada. So I'm going to ask the question and you're going to provide the answer. You don't have to say it in the form of a
just
question.
Just in Canadian tradition. Sorry.
What yeah.
The fuck? Sorry.
Okay, question one.
A boot?
How What's many boot? Provinces are there in Canada? Okay, big pun.
7.
Incorrect.
10.
Idiot. I heard you buzz in.
I crunched 98.
I just wanted to eat it. They're really good.
I'm sorry, Old Miller. I didn't hear the crunch. Old Miller.
10?
10 is correct. Very good.
This game's awesome because I'm just going to keep buzzing in so I can eat the chip. I'm not going to lie.
There we go. Good job, Old Miller. Okay. How many can you name?
Oh,
you have
God.
To say a number first and then somebody can outbid you.
It's like spades.
I can't name a single one.
Okay, so 0. Can anybody name one? King chip. How many can you name?
Name what?
Oarsman.
Name what?
How many provinces can you name? How many of the 10 Canadian provinces can you name?
What are you saying?
Ontario. Quebec.
Okay, anybody else? Anybody else want to take a crack? Okay, those are two. You're cruising along.
Prince Edward Island, Labrador, yeah. Newfoundland, Nunavut, Yukon, Manitoba.
Those are territories.
Oh.
Manitoba's
those
correct.
Those are two different things.
Elkhart.
All right, let's break them down so people know. Yeah, exactly. So the provinces, Alberta, mm-hmm. British Columbia, mm-hmm. Manitoba, mm-hmm. New Brunswick, sure. Newfoundland Classic. And Labrador. That's one province. Nova Scotia, Ontario, Prince Edward Island, Quebec, and Saskatchewan. And then we have three territories, the Northwestern Territories, Nunavut, and the Yukon.
Sounds nice. Like a bunch of communist
gobbledygook. Okay, very good. Glad I got that one right. Okay. Okay, next question. Remember to have those chips ready.
Oh, no. I forgot.
Okay, get a chip ready, idiot.
I'm an idiot. I don't know what to tell you. It says in my name.
What? What are loonies and toonies?
Oh.
Idiot.
Cash money.
Currency. Okay, yeah, it is cash money, but can you give us a little more detail, please?
Loonies, the cost of a bag of milk in school. If you've ever seen the Kroll show, he needs to borrow a loonie from his mom to get a bag of milk. Yeah, it's true. It's fucking true.
Okay, that's good. Okay, a loonie is.
Oh, okay,
no, and yeah, go ahead. Big money, bills. I guess.
No, I was thinking Incorrect. Dollars or cash and coins.
Close. They're actually both coins. A loonie is a $1 coin.
Of course.
It's called such because it has a picture of a loon, a native Canadian bird on one side.
I know.
And a toonie is a $2 coin, named such because it rhymes with loonie. So loonies and toonies, you hear that often up here in Canada. Not to be confused with the American cartoon Looney Tunes, by the way.
Which I was confused by.
Just so you know.
Tiny Tunes. But
yeah. Question number 4. What is a timbit?
A what?
What? Is a timbit. T-I-M-B-I-T. All the Canadians are laughing at you Americans right now for not knowing what a timbit is.
A loon is my second favorite bird.
Can I crunch? Can you hear me? Am I crunching?
Oh, gosh. Old Miller. Yeah, go ahead. Yeah.
A timbit is a saw to chop down a tree.
That's incorrect.
Some sort
they
of...
should do Jeopardy more like this. It's more fun.
Some sort of checkered shirt.
Ooh. We're sorry. Incorrect. Any other guesses? Sweater? No. Yeah.
You didn't. I'm just eating a chip. I don't know. I'm just eating a chip.
Okay. So Timbits, they're donut holes. And they're from the Canadian McDonald's Tim Hortons.
Tim Hortons.
Yeah. Is a fast food restaurant here, and you'll hear a box of Timmies. You'll hear Timbits.
My second favorite Tim.
Double Double. Tim Hortons.
Are they good?
Is a Tim's coffee with two sugars and two creams.
Monk, are
there's
they
one
good?
Up the road. No matter where you are in Canada, there's one just up the road. Okay, next question.
I guess we'll never
this
know.
This Canadian drink concoction is made using vodka, Clamato juice, seasoning, usually Worcestershire and Tabasco.
Worcester.
Sometimes horseradish. And garnish.
Bloody Mary.
Who was that? Who crunched Mary. First? Is that
was Old Miller.
It is not a Bloody Mary. Close. You got the first part right. But what do they call it up here Canada way? Not Bloody, Bloody Suzanne. Suzanne. No.
Okay. Bloody A?
No.
A wet not a Trudeau. A.
Or a Bloody B. Wet Trudeau. Not a wet Trudeau. It seems nobody knows the answer.
Bloody Queen.
Bloody Moose.
Up
Bloody
here
Moose.
In Canada, we refer to it as a Bloody Caesar.
Fuck.
That is a Bloody Caesar. Okay, weird. Next Darn. Question.
Why?
What Plan city juice. In Canada is referred to as the Six?
Ah. Wait, Big I don't know. I thought it was Toronto, but I'm not sure anymore.
Well, you should have trusted your gut there. It is Toronto. Indeed Toronto. And do you know why it's named such?
Because of Drake. Next question.
That's close. I mean, that's why people know, because he refers to Toronto, his home, his native city, as the Six. Before 1998, Toronto was made up of six unique districts that are now all conjoined.
Also known as provinces.
Toronto. Nope. Correct. But the two areas.
Do you remember how much
there...
we knew about Cincinnati? We're like, Neil, can we talk about this tomorrow morning? We're like, can't do it. Okay. We're like, I don't know.
Okay. Four more to go. Get those chips ready. Who
let's
is
get
the richest?
Some, let's get some, four more to go. Let's get who, some Cincinnati trivia.
Who is the richest person in Canada?
The government?
Yeah, nobody's going to know this one. It's David Thompson. David Thompson and Emily, net worth of $52 billion, third generation media magnate, owner of Thompson Reuters. You might have heard of it. Bell Kurt, Canada, yeah. The Globe, and Mail newspapers out of Toronto. A lot going through David Thompson's brain.
Good for
I was
him.
Thinking Tim, I was thinking Tim.
Okay, let's move it.
He's probably pretty rich.
That's a good guess. Who's the tallest person in Canada?
Wayne Gretzky.
I figured you'd laugh at that one. King Chip.
Wayne Gretzky.
Incorrect. Good guess. Anybody
Yao
else?
Yao Ming. Maybe when he's playing skate. The Raptors.
Oh, very good, Dave. I should give you a point for that. It's actually Jerry Sokolsky. Jerry Sokolsky, 7'4.5" from Winnipeg, Manitoba. He declared for the 2004 NBA draft, but in fact was never drafted. He wasn't even good at basketball. He just
I know. I chomped before you answered. Obviously, I had the answer.
You knew Jerry Sokolsky?
So I got two points.
Right. Point for Danny. Okay, name a famous person from Canada. Anybody.
Jonah Hill.
Any famous person.
Seth Rogen.
Wait, Jonah Hill's American.
Jonah Hill is American.
Gilda Radner.
Canadian. Good Crunch. Job, Old Miller. Who is considered the most famous person from Canada? This
Drake.
Is the real question. Not Drake. Brady, you uttered his
probably Art Garfunkel.
Dan
Tim Horton. Tim Horton.
Tim Horton.
I could do this all night.
Wayne Gretzky.
Queen
not
Elizabeth.
Wayne Gretzky, not Tim Horton. It's Justin Trudeau, folks.
Queen Elizabeth II,
the
sir.
Most famous person in Canada. If you write who's the most famous person in Canada into Google or Bing ChatGPT, Justin Trudeau comes back. Okay, last question. I'll wait until I ask the question. What
oh,
is
Final
Canada
Jeopardy?
Considered number one in the world for? They recently got a number one ranking. What was it for?
Safest country.
Very, very close. Big pun. That was part of the answer.
Best chips.
King Chip. Stop the music. Stop the show.
Yeah, exporting Jewish comedians.
Go ahead. That's incorrect.
They have to be number one in that.
Okay, let's just go ahead and get right to the answer. The answer is as ranked by U.S. News in 2021.
Brady got it.
Canada ranked number one in the world for
lowest amount of murders.
Life. Quality of life. Dude. What do you know? I got 3 years younger when I moved up here right across.
That was good.
I should have changed
great.
The answer down
you look
to
happier.
Potato chips. That would have been a better segue.
It would have.
They were actually number two in the world for potato chips right behind the United States. And not even the United States, but just Pennsylvania. It's like Pennsylvania and then Canada was right behind them.
I believe.
Can I tell you guys what I'm drinking before we get into WorChip?
Yeah, let's do a quick
yeah, let's tell you,
drink
Monk
round.
Monk is
drinking
drink.
Drinks.
the whip Kool-Aid, the Canadian drinks. Kool-Aid is what Monk's drinking, because I don't even recognize him anymore.
I'm just loving where I'm living, okay? I'm having a wonderful life. Great quality
do
of
you
life.
Love oh, it, Steve? Great movie. Honest question, do you love it?
I've become more and more accustomed
great.
To
yeah. Stay
that sounds like love
no.
to me.
That's a hard
the air
no.
is the air is pure. I've never felt safer.
Okay.
There's a lot to do.
Didn't you come so, home yes, to what happened, a murder?
What about
next
your
neighbor?
What about your neighbor who was murdered?
Yeah, but that was rare.
Yeah, what about your neighbor who was murdered right in front of your eyes? Yeah. Love it or leave it is a one-way
it was
ticket.
A tough situation. But we're working on it. We're
no, it's still love it or listed on HGTV.
I'll tell that story in another episode. Dave, what are you drinking?
Tonight, I'm drinking 19 Crimes Cabernet as my side drink right now. But nice. Really what I'm drinking as has never been seen before. Jack Daniels paired with Coca-Cola, two of the biggest brands in the world. It tastes like Coca-Cola in one can. It was they had Jack and Cola before, which is generic cola. This tastes like Coca-Cola with Jack Daniels. It's kind of incredible. So go out there and get it next month.
Nice. Okay.
I wanted to do like a sober round and get Heineken Double Zero, but I didn't, like Big Pun did last week. So Pun, I want to hear what you're drinking this week. Are you drinking water? Are you drinking Coors Light? You got that big meeting tomorrow.
You know exactly what I'm drinking. Aforementioned horrible start to the show. So I pivoted from a beer and alcohol, I'll save for another show, and went to my Rocksteady Coors Light. I needed something just to mellow me out, to harsh my tones, to wet the palate before the all dress. I've got the CL smoothie. I'll swing it. I'll popcorn it over to King Chip.
Thanks, Bun. Glad to hear you're doing really well. I am drinking a Moosehead Lager, which is a classic Canadian beer. This always reminds me of my time spent up north watching the moose, listen to the loon scream and cry from her lake perch, and have to deal with all those passive-aggressive, somewhere on the spectrum Canadians that folks have to deal with up there. But I'm happy to bring a little bit of their chip or the solids to my liquid. You know what I'm talking about, right, idiot?
I do. I'm drinking a Space Dust IPA for that Brady actually brought over to my home. Quite tasty. I'm on my second one so far for the cast. I'm fine, Steve. How are you?
I am great. Thank you so much for asking. And I will round it out with a Canada Dry. This is a Canada Dry ginger ale. This was bottled proudly right here in Canada in Mississauga, Ontario. Let's go ahead and crack that open.
Ooh, yeah.
Hopefully it doesn't spray everywhere.
Second week without an alcoholic beverage.
Actually, I am recovering from a bit of an illness.
I think he's pregnant.
Yeah, and so I'm just trying to keep it. I'm trying to stay focused.
Kind of love a good Canada Dry. I'm not gonna lie.
And I couldn't pass it up. Usually,
are you Canada Dry or Schweppes? Are you Canada Dry or Schweppes? What are you?
Danny, it's so funny you mentioned that. I have Schweppes in the refrigerator right now. I don't know why. I think it was like I went to Donair Dude to get a doner kebab.
Mm-hmm.
They had a meal deal, and in their cooler they had Schweppes, and I was like, okay, I'll have ginger ale. I don't want any of that other crazy soda. Anyhow, it's still in the fridge because I half drank it like a week ago. So I think I like Canada Dry. I think I'm a Canada Dry guy.
Canada Dry,
a special trip just before the episode to go out and get this because of the name. Made from real ginger. What do you know?
Mm. Beth would get heartburn when she was pregnant and always wanted Schweppes.
Mm. Just interesting.
Saying. Yeah.
Well, it's fun to say.
It is. It's a lot of fun to say.
Okay, Dave, why don't you take us into the weekly worship here? Why don't you just give us a little announcement?
Ladies and gentlemen, a beautiful bag that we have here this week from Canada. Nobody could be more excited about this bag. This bag is what this podcast is for, is bringing this to your awareness. You're going to get the best of the best in this week's weekly worship.
Very well done.
Yeah.
Old Yeller, Old Miller there. Okay, a couple quick facts about Old Dutch. Because surprise, surprise, ladies and gentlemen, this chip brand did not start in Canada. This chip brand, Old Dutch Foods, Inc., started in St. Paul, Minnesota in 1934. This was unbeknownst to me before maybe 48 hours ago. It was founded by Karl J. Marx, not to be confused with the German philosopher. He chose the name Old Dutch because Dutch was associated with cleanliness and quality, something we're familiar with all the Dutch, Pennsylvania Dutch, all the chips out there, and can't blame Karl. In 1952, he sold it to the Anensen family, a father, Vernon, and his two sons, Stephen and Eric. And it was in 1954 that they opened a plant in Winnipeg, Manitoba, to feed the hungry mouths of the Canadian market. So if you go to the olddutchfoods.ca website, they mention nothing about Minnesota. They claim that Old Dutch started in Winnipeg as a little chip company with a lot of heart. It says the company, you know, it has a timeline of their existence. And in 1954, it says company begins in Winnipeg, Manitoba. So I'm not sure. I couldn't really figure out where this split occurred. But if we fast forward to present day, there are 7 potato chip facilities in Canada and 11 distribution centers in Canada. And there are only 2 in the United States. They have their headquarters in St. Paul, and then their corn production facility somewhere up in Minnesota as well. So it started off as a U.S. Chip company, but it's very much become the fabric of Canada, Canadian culture,
and Old Dutch. It saddens me a little bit.
You that we lost a good one? That the U.S. lost a good one? But, you know,
yeah.
Maybe it just and didn't get enough fanfare. Yeah.
Still delicious.
Yeah. So anyhow, there are, you know, they're known for their boxed twin packs, which reminds me of Grippos. They're known, they have many varietals, types. They have originals, what we're munching on today. Rip L are their kind of like wavy chips. Ridgies, they're very tight, hard, more like Ruffles. Dutch Crunch, they have Ariba, which is like a Dorito-like chip. Restaurante, it's like a Tostitos-like chip. Cheese Puffers, Corn Chips, Crunchies, Twists. Even roasted and salted sunflower seeds. And if you go into any grocery store here in Canada, you will see a wall of Old Dutch flavors and packaging. It dominates every single aisle. It's like a white wall. So every bag is primarily white and then, you know, a different flavor with a different kind of banner. And they have flavors all dressed. We're munching on tonight. They have ketchup, au gratin, creamy dill, Mexican chili, crispy bacon, Parmesan and black pepper. And then I also sent a bag of the sour cream and green onion, which, spoiler alert, might be my favorite chip of all time.
Yeah.
So many really good flavors and wonderful potatoes that they are digging up here in the Canadian soil. So anyhow, that's just a little background on Old Dutch and where we are. I'm excited to find out a little bit more even before our next round. But why don't we just go ahead and get into it? Why don't... King Chip, I saw your eyebrows raising there quite a bit. I'm not sure if you were believing anything that I was slinging out. Why don't you get us started on this bag? Let's go ahead and talk about packaging.
Yeah, good place to start, but no better place to start than the bag itself. And you might have alluded to this, Steve. Old Dutch was known for having a boxed bag. Maybe that's what that double pack was. And I think that was even a thing back when it was an old Minnesota brand, was not really served as a loose bag, but served in a box. You can still buy Old Dutch in the U.S. I'd recommend bobsproduce.com or olddutch.bobsproduce.com. They're an authorized web retailer for Old Dutch, have been since 1995, and they could ship all Old Dutch varietals, excluding the Canadian ones like All Dressed and things that have like maple cream on it and other sort of weird things. But looking at this bag as it is, non-boxed and bagged as it is, this is a beautiful bag. It reminds me of, well, All Dressed chips, which I'm not allowed to get in most places here in America. So there's a little bit of an exotic element to it. The other exotic element to it, when you look at this thing, is it's almost like sort of a paper or like a plastic Rosetta Stone. All these chips from Canada are, because they've got a little bit of English, a little bit of French, and then a little bit of the hieroglyphics. On here, you've got a windmill, you've got different fruits and vegetables down at the bottom, different old English fonts that I can't really read, and then the different other symbols that have to do with commercial regulation and whatnot, like GF for gluten-free, which is a big stance that Old Dutch took, gluten-free. That's basically the entirety of their manifesto on the back. I'm not even going to read it. It's complete garbage. It's just an right. announcement that yeah. they're gluten-free. It's one of the saddest manifestos I've ever seen. Right. But it does have a windmill.
Agreed.
It does have a windmill. It does have all dressed. It shows the chips in large scale. And then it shows some of the elements that go into it, but I don't think it's totally accurate, right? It's hard to represent ketchup, barbecue, and salt and vinegar mm-hmm. in a normal format of how people display flavors on a bag. So they show a tomato, green onion, garlic, and then a pound of like orange brown seasoning. That could be any number of different things. But the other cool thing is it says all dressed, and then it has the French version, which is assassins. So the French word for all dressed is assassins, which is kind of cool. Like it sort of sneaks up and kills you with flavor or something like that. Most of this stuff I don't really understand too much, but I am attracted to the colors of red, yellow, blue, and white. And the general gist of this and the mystery of the plastic Rosetta Stone, I'm going to give it a 5 out of 5. This is a top-notch bag.
Love it. Love to hear it. Why don't you go ahead and kick it off, kick it around to somebody else.
We're going to kick it to Big Pun.
Thank you, King Chip. What a lovely ranking. You covered a lot of the main points. This is a bag. There's a lot of elements of this bag that I really like. There's some elements I don't. Just to call out the positives that you already mentioned, everyone knows I love seeing the chip. Showing the chip itself and the ingredients and what I'm getting inside that bag, that's a beautiful thing. Their logo, their old Dutch with red surrounded by yellow with the windmill, it's all beautiful. The rest of it is kind of like, reminds me of a Ruffles, like an old school Ruffles bag, a little bit of copycat. It's a little plain, a little boring. Some of the French on there is fun. It's unique for a dumb American like me. I think this is going to be my lowest rating of any category tonight. I know for a fact it is because I've already been eating these. It's a fine bag. It's a good bag. It's a solid, strong bag. I'm going to give it a 3.8 out of 5. Old Miller, bring me home. Old Miller to Old Dutch.
Hey, guys. I bleepin' love this bag. This bag is gorgeous. I feel like this bag is lying to me. This bag gives me such high hope for what's inside this bag. The yellow and blue surrounding the top and bottom is the most like regal 1400s. You're carrying like a flag through the town square. We're bringing the chips. They're both French and English throughout the entire bag is beautiful. The old Dutch that's kind of like highlighted with the yellow highlighter behind the bag, beautiful. So also as far as the ingredients on the front, the garlic. So you kind of feel like, hey, there's a whole tomato in here. There's a whole head of garlic. I don't taste that much garlic. But I do like the pile of 2 to 3 tablespoons of seasonings that you know you're about to get with inside that bag. But on the back, we have toutes les croustilles des pommes de terre old Dutch sont sans gluten. Il s'agit donc de grignotines à savoir sans tracas, une autre bonne raison d'amère old Dutch. I feel like it's a beautiful little both French and English thing we've got going on in this bag. This bag is a 4.8 out of 5. Idiot. Let's hear more.
David, I'm right there with you. Sorry, I was sometimes it's really hard to go from spreadsheet to unmuting. You know what I mean? It's really difficult as I'm keeping track. This is a beautiful bag. I quite love this bag. Guys, this is amazing. This is our first shipment from Canada. I feel like we need to up the energy. This is exciting stuff. We got an all-dressed chip. I'm pumped. Yes, blow that up, Stevesy. This is a beautiful bag. Look at this. You guys have called it out. The old Dutch writing. I am a sucker for 70s style-ish, like kind of 60s, 70s styles-ish design. And I like this. Miller, you called the highlighted behind the red. Normally, that's ugly as sin, like putting a little highlighter yellow behind red on top of white. And I kind of love it for that exact reason, because it's red and yellow, which makes you hungry. It's showing the ingredients, which I love. I totally dig. Then they have a completely different font for all dressed. Looks a little bit out of place and weird, and I really appreciate that. But I can see how templatized the bag is, which I'm a big fan of. On the back, when it goes into the actual manifesto, which, David, you read beautifully, but I'm going to read it in English. All of Old Dutch potato chips are gluten-free, a worry-free snack, or a worry-free snacking experience for all of our great customers. Another reason to love Old Dutch. They're assuming arrogantly that you already love all the other qualities about it. Like, there's no other reason why they listed anywhere in the bag why you will love it. They just assume you love it. Love the arrogance. It's a beautiful bag. It's got my weird 70s design style. I will go to this every single time. I'm going to give it a 4.4 out of 5 in terms of bag. I think it's a handsome bag. Steve, over to you.
Yeah, it's a beautiful bag. There's no question about it. And when you go into the grocery store and you see that white wall of all of these bags, it is something to behold. You stop in your tracks and you say, hold on. Well, you know, there's a competitor, a real competitor to Frito-Lay here. And then within that white wall are all these intricate flavors. So you're seeing a lot of ingredients. The chips on this bag, on the front of this bag, are identical to the chips inside this bag. I love that. The flag, David, you talking about medieval, you know, what, 15th century, like flags carrying in at the front of a battle. I love that analogy. And looking here, what is Canada known for? What did they rank number one for in the U.S. News 2021 list?
Windmills.
Quality of life.
Oh.
No, not windmills. It says quality lives here. And that is true. And what do I love about chip brands that speak the truth? Everything. There's a lot going on this bag. Primary colors, of course, but there's ingredients, there's multiple fonts. There's a lot of different writing, but it still somehow calms me down. And I think what it is this windmill. They've tapped into the grace of the Dutch culture and life. And when I see that windmill, I just feel the wind across my beard. And I just want to pick up a bag and take it home and eat it in private behind a locked door. And Danny, you have a comment to add to the calmness that you feel?
You're inspiring me because the Dutch are a very straightforward people, stereotypically, mm-hmm. Abrupt. And hey, I'm going to give you just what it is. And we're Dutch and this is what we think. Mm-hmm. And that's what this bag is, right? It's kind mm-hmm. of encapsulating that. Like it's not no frills, but it's not insanely over the top. And I really dig it. So mm-hmm. I'm in round and I'm in charge of spreadsheets. So I'm going to bump mine up to a 4.5. Thanks, Steve.
Wow.
Over to you.
Good. And I was going into this with a 4.6 and I convinced myself to make it a 4.7, listening to myself talk about how wonderful this bag is. And I'm having a hard time right now, hard pressed.
You're persuasive.
Find a better bag in my brain. I love this bag. You guys shouldn't hasn't be talked
so,
about bag.
You guys shouldn't big, been, big be pun, so you afraid.
About, have you talked about bag yet?
Just go I'm for afraid. The 5, guys.
I'm just living just my life.
Go for the 5.
I'm afraid.
You got to open five, up. Give it may everything be coming. Everything.
Okay, Brady, that's great. Let's go into crunch. Let's go to crunch. Let's go back to Danny Boy. I want to know how your tongue feels, how your mouth feels. And let's hear that crunch.
Oh, I'm going to hear crunch. Before I give you a crunch, I want to say that my best before date on the bag is February 24th, 2023, which is a week away, right? What's yours? Steve?
I'm local. I picked my bag up last week. Mine's April 19th.
Okay. So mine's I'm assuming 24. Mine's been shipped. Mine has been through the air and all this stuff. I want you to listen to this crunch. And mine is coming up on its expiration date. I'm assuming there's some dullness from the travel and from whatever. I bet a fresh bag is crunchier. I'm going to give it a 4 because it's really solid for how close it is to the end date. Spoiler alert, that's going to be my lowest ranking because this chip is good. I'm going to give it 4.1, actually, because that's pretty darn good. It's come from Canada. It's up against its expiration date. I bet a fresh one is unreal. Steve, I'm actually going to give it right back to you because I want to hear how is a fresh
one. Good, because I love that's. I mean, what I love so much about this brand is the freshness of their potatoes. I think their potatoes are possibly second to none. And so these are a thin chip. They're not a kettle. They're not ridge. They're not wavy. They're not meant to, you know, be shards of glass in your mouth or big crunch. But smooth, crisp.
It's comfortable. It's like a comfortable crunch.
That's a good way to put it. It is really comfortable. It's definitely in the 4s for me. I do prefer maybe more of a hot kettle overall. It is hard to kind of, maybe I've had the Dutch Crunch, which is their kettle varietal, and it's like fantastic. I've had that more as original flavor and jalapeno flavor. I've never had the Dutch Crunch all dressed. I'm going to have to go right back to the grocery store and pick those up. But I will give this a, let's see, I'm going to go ahead and give it a 4-3 on the crunch for an original thin. This is very good. Big bun.
Okay, boomer.
King Chip wants fives across the board. Look, for the style of chip that it is and the crunch that you get, this should be an immediate 5 out of 5. That's just the way it is. It's unbelievable. I will not give that because the way that I rate my crunch is just the heaviness, the actual crunch factor. A kettle Stop is always going to be closer Stop to a 5
walls.
Than
Start
this.
Building bridges, Kev. Stop building walls. Just, build bridges.
If people want to know the crunch level, it's consistent. But I can't rave enough about, Monk has covered it, the quality of this chip. The crunch, it is so thin. I would say, obviously, you said it's comfortable, it's light, it's crispy. This is fun for me. You should not have this type of crunch with this thin of chip. It just should not be the case. It's going to be a lower rating than it should be getting because it's so perfect for the style of chip. But for crunch alone and crunch, 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 there are higher ones. I'm going to give this a 4.2 out of 5. While noting asterisks, it is the best of its vertical.
Good to know. Why don't we swing it on to King Chip? He seems to have some thoughts.
Thanks, Steve. Yeah, I've always got thoughts. You know, one for pun. Yeah, just reshape your tone more into a bridge rather than a battleship. That's the only advice I can give you today. And to Steve, you're untethered, man. You're out of bounds. I think you've been up north too long. You've been living in the upside down world up there. And I think you've lost all perspective. And when you do come back to America, you spend time doing in-house hibachi or things that aren't even real, dude. So you're losing touch. However, with these chips, I've got to give it to you because when we're talking about crunch, when I bite into these guys, immediately,
that was a great soundbite.
My pupils dilate 10x. Mm. Oh, yeah. I'm feeling it in my blood. Like, what's racing through my head is a song that was on my 2022 Best of Roundup playlist from Spotify. If you've ever heard, I'm not recalling the title of the song, but that song is going, it's about Canada, and it's going through my head right now. And it's a 5 out of 5 crunch. It's a crunch that I associate with euphoria. It's a crunch I associate with sitting on the shore, not of a beach in Maui, but on more of a rocky shore with some birch and hemlock around me and everything, and listen to the cry of the loon down yonder. So I'm at peace. I'm at 5. End of story.
Danny, can you give me a 4-4, please? Can you up mine one?
Oh, yeah. I was just going to say that.
Update
4.4.
Yeah. Okay, 4-4. I think 4-4 is around. I mean, and David, I don't mean to take away from your crunch rating, and it's coming very soon, but like the amount of flavor that's also in this thin crunch,
that's flavor,
like,
which we're going to get to.
I know, we're going to get to it, but anyway.
I got so much
Miller,
to say.
Yeah.
Wait, are we we're doing crunch right now, and that
yeah,
and
we're
that
doing
taste,
crunch,
right?
But we all want to get the flavor.
Yeah,
we all want to get the flavor.
Yeah, so okay,
Dave, why don't you do both? I want you to do crunch and the flavor, crunch and flavor all together. Of course, take us
okay.
away.
So with these chips don't cross me as like the best crunch of a potato chip ever. It's kind of a standard crunch, but like as I'm crunching more, I'm really digging the thinness of this chip. But it's not spectacular. This crunch lands at like a 3.7 for me as far as the crunch goes. Okay. But let me segue into flavor. And I feel like flavor should be moved to last because this is a flavor that works up on you. To bear with me, and if you are a new listener and you've just started listening to David rambles. So if you need to fast forward to the next person, go ahead. But let me tell you what's happening when I taste this chip. When I taste this chip, I used to tell these guys when I was in college that the best cinematic scene in any movie was the scene in Ratatouille where the critic tastes the actual Ratatouille for the first time. Dan, when we were hanging out with Dan this weekend, he turned me on to two different things. The Beatles, Don't Let Me Down, which I had heard a lot about this shit from you guys and from my father-in-law, said, hey, when Catherine's grandfather used to take them up to Canada, they would get Old Dutch all dressed all the time. So I had heard a lot of things. So Don't Let Me Down is kind of like the theme of this chip. When I first tasted this, it kind of let me down a little bit. So to put this all together, the scene that I have when I taste this chip, it takes me back to the first time I tasted Kraft macaroni and cheese with ketchup in it. I remember my brother Clem showed me, you pour ketchup in it and you have like a very vinegary taste. And I remember that moment from when I was probably 4 or 5 years old to this moment of tasting these chips for the first time. Very like vinegary, salty, kind of sweet taste towards the end. I wasn't the biggest fan at first, but that's why I'm thinking we move taste towards the end, because sometimes taste builds, sometimes taste matures on our tongues and throughout the process. So it has grown on me. To follow up on this and to end real quick, my favorite movie with that cinematic scene was the Ratatouille moment, like I just described. But Dan reminded me that the best cinematic scene of any movie ever was when Margot Tenenbaum walks off the bus in the Royal Tenenbaums with, Nico playing Nico in the background.
Yeah.
Great
music. Nico playing these days.
Great, Ritchie, great yeah. scene. Yeah. So Jackson to wrap Brown, it all up, I think that for the taste of these chips, it has grown on me. It probably went from a 3.1 all the way up to like a 4.2 throughout eating wow. this episode. So right now the stock is at 4.2. on to idiot. I would love to hear more from you.
Thank you, David. And thank you, Steve. I can't.
You're welcome.
It's hard for me to articulate. So I gave a shout out to Justin, who I cannot shout out enough, because my friend Justin Carter introduced me to all dressed chips. The flavor profile of this, I mentioned this in Ep 1 or in Season 1, that I was searching for my love, my chip love, which I thought was sweet and sassy. Mm. Guys, I think I found my true romance. Wow. The flavoring of the all dressed chip that we're eating right now, it is so complex for like a standard chip that I feel like you can get. The depth of the tang that you get with the, it's like a salt and vinegar chip. Mm-hmm. Mashed with a barbecue chip, mashed with like a little bit of a, like there's the sweetness, there's the flavor, there's the tang, there's a little bit of heat. It is phenomenal. Might be my favorite taste I've ever had with a chip. It's why I was really pressuring to get this chip before the Super Bowl, because I wanted to sit on the couch, get my little gross idiot fingies in here and eat this while I watch Pat Mahomes do his magic. And I'm giving this a 5 out of 5. And I feel like nice. That's go low there. Because yeah, wow. this is phenomenal.
Yeah.
Love it. Love it. Love it. Love it. Love it. Over to you, King Chip Flavor.
Thanks, Dan. I have been jonesing for these ever since I got out of prison. And I'm talking about the whole shebang. This is the next, this is the next bloody bag that's going to come up to that, and really does go beyond it. I think the whole shebang has a lot going on, and almost just slightly too much going on. I think they put everything in yes. there where you kind of mix all the colors and you get a little bit brown. It was like, if they would have just throttled back, you know, half a throttle, I'm not really sure how that works, but just less than what they were, I think they'd come closer to what Old Dutch and a lot of the other all-dressed flavors out there have come to attain. And it really is a fantastic flavor. You guys know how head over heels I was about whole shebang. I'm really experiencing a lot of that here today with you all. So it's probably not going to surprise you too much that I'm going to give this a 5 out of 5 on flavor.
Doesn't surprise me, but I'm still impressed.
Thank you.
Okay, I'll go next.
Yeah, go.
I'll go next. Yeah, everybody's already mentioned it. The balance here is truly what's magical for me in particular, because I'm not a salt and vinegar guy. I really don't. They're too biting, but the ketchup or the barbecue evens that out. I've never had a ketchup chip. I've been saving myself. I've been living
in
here
my
for
chipmunk
2 years,
from Justin. In my chipmunk
and I've
from
never,
Justin.
No. How are those, Danny? How are straight up ketchup chips?
Hated it. No, didn't hate it. No, didn't hate it. A ketchup chip tastes like the one fry that you get. So say you get crinkle cut fries at a burger mm-hmm. place, and you squirt bottle ketchup it onto the yep. like onto the greasy mm-hmm. little thing.
It's the last.
And you get
fry.
That one fry that's at the bottom of the, and you eat it, and it's too much ketchup. So sometimes you have to yeah, pair it with
exactly.
another chip.
Right.
Or another fry. That's what it tastes like. And it was right. too, just a little too much, but it's good. But you're like, I wish I had another. Just
yeah.
tone it down. That was my, else. That was my take.
It's never yeah. been appetizing to me. That's why I've
it's
never
not
gotten
terrible,
it. But it's in this bag and the salt and vinegar is balancing that out. And then the barbecue's coming in and the sour cream's coming in.
Dude, I want to hang out with this bag. I want to hang out with this
flavor. The whole shebang. And so actually great. Some of the other all dressed that I've had are way too caked on, way too over the top. And just, really not for me. I won't eat the covered bridge all dressed ever again. I think they're terrible. The Ruffles ones were actually very good. These actually the Ridgies version of Old Dutch I think are my favorite because like even the Ridge potatoes. But this flavor is impeccable. I never thought I would like it this much. You all know why. This is a 4.9 flavor to me. I could eat these all day long and not get over tanged, over zested. There's just a really wonderful balance going on here. Big
oh, it's beautiful. I want to keep talking about it. I guess stop.
Sorry, Monk. So would you say that you prefer Ridgie's version than the than whatever flat chips or whatever?
It's kind of a toss up to me right now. The Ridgie's
are fun
really.
To say.
I believe you've more... had the Ridgie's too, King Chip, didn't you?
I have. I mean, if anything, yeah, it's going to give Ridgie's a little bit dressing. Extra crunch.
Right.
Which okay. Okay, noted. Also, can we just pause for a minute and give a shout out to Dan Sullivan for, I always forget that he has a spreadsheet open during all this thing and he's logging everybody's numbers. I hear all these numbers and they just
call,
wash man. Right over me. Good I'm call. Not even paying attention. And Dan does this yeah. every day, all day, in and out, or every week, or every few weeks, or however often we do this thing, every couple months. And I just want to say,
hire Dan and give him a promotion every time you see him.
You big old idiot!
Thank you, Brady, and thank you for the beer. This beer is delicious. I'm a big idiot, but I can put numbers into a spreadsheet. I can do that.
This is a 4.7 for me.
Ooh, flavor. That's a big number for Kev.
That's a big number for me. You guys have touched on everything. Sully mentioned it, especially like ketchup, salt, and vinny. Those are not flavor profiles that typically align with high ratings or things that I ever seek out. But it's the balance of this that is incredible. It's outrageous. The whole shebang was really fun and really tasty. If you guys remember that bag, though, the bag was almost wet. It was so
oh,
greasy
yeah.
and disgusting.
It had grease stains. It had grease stains
exactly.
on the bag. Yeah.
That like this is everything it wishes it was. Yep. It's so much cleaner. It's so much fresher. You guys, we've talked about the flavor ad nauseum. One major component that the Monk pointed out earlier that I can't harp on enough is just the potato itself that yeah. adds to the flavor. It's I think Old Dutch, and I'm reserving judgment until I have the sour cream and onion, which I think
can't wait,
might
by the
be
way.
Just by bag alone might be my favorite chip of all time. I think Old Dutch is skyrocketing to the best chip brands I've ever had. And that's wow. based on two bags of chips. I love the flavor. It's so subtle, yet so complex. It's dancing in my mouth. It's unbelievable. It's a 4.7.
It's watching Patrick Mahomes play quarterback is what it feels like in terms of flavor. Pulling back to the
smooth.
Super Bowl.
High
it's,
ankle sprains.
It's just got high ankle sprains. You're kind of like, is it overweight? But everyone says, like, no, that's fine. You're like, I don't think that looks like an athlete, but he can throw, and it's great. So it's perfect, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Cool. Danny, why don't you take us into dust?
Oh, yeah. From a dust perspective, I mean, I can't say enough about this old chip. It's beautiful. The flavor's great. This dust is fantastic because it's perfectly coated, where every single chip has a ton of flavor. But it's not ridiculous. You can walk into a boardroom and not be seen. They might smell it on you because of the tang. You can grip a steering wheel, and I think you're going to get away with it. But honestly, with this flavor, even if you crash and die, might be worth it. So overall, I'm going to give this, because of how good the flavor is, I'm giving this also a 5 out of 5 because it is phenomenal. It's perfectly coated. It's one of my favorite, honestly, like balance in terms of flavor chips we've ever had or that I've ever had. So I'm going to give it a 5 out of 5 in terms of dust.
Wow. Nice.
Miller, I'm coming to you.
Yeah.
Thank you, Dan. I think the dust on this is beautiful. You're right. The consistency is a 100. I just wish there was more dust. It's a 4 for me. I love it. Beautifully dusted. Doesn't stick to your fingers. I feel like you can go into boardroom. You can get out of Dodge. You can do any of these things. You can write on white legal paper if you needed to and probably not see too much residue. Chipmunk, what do you feel about this dust?
It's a 4 for me as well, David, because it has too much dust. I don't think I need to. It is a dry dust.
Erroneous.
It's not sticky, which is fantastic. I can't. It's a balance with all of these categories, really. Like the flavor and the dust do go together. I can't give it a high flavor score and then a low dust score. It's got to have dust if it needs to have flavor, you know. But I think there. I can't tell. I haven't really wiped my hands, so this is like half a bag of dust on my fingies right now, which you can see all these flavor crystals. It's great. It's dry. I could get out of Dodge if I wanted to, but it's there and it's a little annoying to me. So I'm going to give it a 4 out of 5 on dust. Big pun.
Do you have a serviette on hand?
Have a rebuttal.
Do you have a serviette on hand? Something ready to sign and give off?
A big one right here.
Nice. Wish I could see you.
I'm keeping it consistent. I'm keeping it chip. I'm going 4.7 on dust. I think the only thing holding this back, there is such thing as too much dust. I don't know if we found it just yet. I could use just a little bit more. It doesn't need it by any stretch of the imagination. It's perfect as is, but I love it so much. I want a little bit more. I think if I'm kissing my father on the lips, he may not let me leave. That's how much dust, and that's how much he's going to like it. He's going to hold the back of my head. It's a 4.7.
Brady, I think over to you. Classic father move, by the way. Hold the back of your head. Just moves you to get a little dust on. Classic.
What can I say? The dust is quite adequate. I mean, one of the great miracles that I've never been able to fathom with a lot of these chip companies is how you get such complex, robust, rich, intense flavor profiles, mixing all of these different, you know, factors from ketchup, which I think is a tomato or some sort of egg-based product, to salt and vinegar, which are different ingredients all to themselves, I'm sure. How do you end up creating something, a chip lathered in this taste, but and not have half the bag filled with you know, seasoning that's making this up? So the way that they're able to balance the high complexity of flavors, this isn't a barbecue chip, right? There's a lot going on here, as we've talked about, and they're still managing a pretty a good, adequate level of dust. I'm not a dust head. I hate a wet dust. I hate a dry dust. I hate too little dust. I hate too much dust. So adequate to me, although it doesn't sound real good, actually means a lot and does sound real nice to these ears. So this is a 5 out of 5 on dust. End of story, full stop.
Hey, that's great. I think that's our dust rankings. I'm not mistaken. I'm trying to check out the big board here. Why don't we round it out with value? Idiot, why don't you tell us how you feel about the value and or values
sure.
of this experience?
I got a lot of feelings about the value, Steve. First, it was sent to me by a good friend of mine from Canada. It's a chip brand I've never had before. A flavor that you cannot purchase in the United States. The flavor not only delivered my expectations, exceeded my expectations. Chatting with my friends, I had a chipinalia, which allowed me to get these chips over to my buddies. Might be my, spoiler alert, favorite chip of all time. 5 out of 5 is not high enough, but that's wow. what I'm going to give it. 5 out of 5 in terms of overall values, because of all those things combined, and in a dark time in my life, I needed this chip, and it's beautiful. Big pun, over to you.
I'm going to give it a 4.8 on value. I just want to start with the rankings on a lot of these because I'm just so stunned by how much I love these chips. Again, all dress is never going to be my first choice. I think if I'm ever getting them again, it's only going to be these. I did like the Ruffles all dress, but I really trust the quality and the freshness of all the flavors in the potatoes here. I'm stunned by it. We have another Old Dutch to get to. Spoiler alert, I've gotten into those. It's an absolute disaster. I couldn't wait, dude.
You couldn't wait. You broke
good
open
disaster because or bad?
Good for you.
It's a disaster for me. It's a disaster for the podcast. I broke contain. I started with these. Those looked even better. They are. Old Dutch is an incredible brand that I need to figure out how to get my little Chipinalia hands on more often. I don't know if I'll love all their flavors, but they are undeniably a clean, crisp, wonderfully flavored. Oh, I don't even feel full or disgusting eating these. That's the other thing. You eat a bunch of chips and you don't feel good. These just keep going. There's no stopping. It's a 4.8. I loved everything about it. The only thing is, like, it's the only flavor that I just wouldn't be always drawn to, but they do it so well that it's a 4.8.
I'll go next. I can't stop either. I've put this bag outside of arm's reach because I keep going back to it. I've also pretty much drank this entire bottle of Canada Dry. I'm just living a happy existence right now. And Danny, the only thing better than receiving a box of chips is sending a gigantic box of chips.
It was like Christmas morning, Steve.
That are all individually ziplocked, which I realized was totally asinine because I paid for ground shipping. and so it really pretty much made no difference, I think. I don't know.
These were tasty. Like they were wonderful.
Underground chip tunnel that these go through.
Channel. That's the channel.
Yeah, the tunnel. That's right. Anyhow, the experience, if you can't already tell, is just this is why we do this. Sending shipments and trying new chips. I mean, I'm in a different country, for Christ's sake, and sending these chips along, and I can't wait till we get to the other bags, but this one in particular, this is a classic Canadian brand with a classic Canadian flavor, and it's a 5 out of 5 all the way home, all the way out of Dodge, and then back into Dodge and settling in bed. Just after this ChipCast. 5 out of 5. Davo, how do you feel about the value?
Like I mentioned, Steve, thank you. This is what this podcast is all about, is like sharing a chip like this so that we know what chips are out there in the world that we haven't tried yet. So I think all in all, probably roughly with gas and shipping and everything, I probably paid around $20 for the single bag of chips. Last week was the Urban, around $16 for me after taxes. So these chips are getting expensive these days, but quality lives here. These are a quality chip, I swear to God. Anybody who is interested in chips or snacks or wants to bring something to the party, if you spent $20 by having your friend up in Canada ship you a bag of chips, it's worth the table talk. It's worth the conversation. I wasn't the ultimate fan of the flavor. There are some, they can make that windmill bigger on the bag. So overall, I want to put it at a 4.4. I think it's a great bag of chips and a great experience all in all for what I experienced. On to the next.
Well, we can't.
On to the next bag, he's saying. He's like, Send more bags, I think. He'll pay $20 all day. I agree with you, David. I'll just vamp a little bit while Brady's still reconnecting for the 12th time this evening. Here he comes.
So I was thinking we should round this out by throwing it over to King Chip.
Hi, thank you very much. From the table talk to pillow talk, quality lives here in this bag. And I don't know if anybody's mentioned this yet, but this is really the reason for the podcast, or I think what makes this sort of special, that we're all able to experience this sort of far-flung chip from way, 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 way up north in a little area that nobody ever even thinks about in America. And it's a part of America, which is the craziest sort of thing. But nobody in America even knows that it's there. And so I guess I'll start with the goods and the bads. The bads
or the good, I appreciated the value. I value the bag. All right, we'll start with that. I value the bag. I value everything that was inside of the bag. It was an expensive bag with the shipping and the all this stuff. And I think Steve still probably paid too much for all the other stuff that we didn't cover. But it ended up being about an Irvin's style bag, you know, upward of $10 or more. So that's what we call a premium bag. And if you got a premium bag, you've got to have way a premium chip. What's up?
You got to spread that across all the bags. You can't just give all that to this bag.
Well, if you spread it across the bags, it was $10.
I'd give it to this bag, and I'd keep my rankings.
I think it was.
We're trying to bring down costs.
$50 for five bags, and that was probably just to cover just the shipping. So it's an Irvin's. It equates to an Irvin's, which I think Irvin's. I gave a five on values because I had agreed with everything that boy did to bring those chips from nothing but stuff you'd find on the bottom of his restaurant's floor to things that you're going to find in the mouth of Americans and Chinese people and everybody in between all across the globe. So that man's done more for chips, for one single brand of chips, than any other chip maven that I can talk about in such a short period of time. But with Old Dutch, I do have to say, even though they've done a great spin zone sort of O'Reilly factor thing on just like gaslighting the whole fucking world and saying that this is a Canadian chip, even though it was homegrown in Minnesota, it was American Dutch or American German or Lord knows what it was about. America created this. We passed it off to Canada, so we gave them something. We gave them something to do, and I will give them credit because they introduced
three
this flavor.
Out of five.
They introduced this flavor, Dan.
Mm-hmm.
Idiot. Idiot means you don't speak. All right, you certainly don't speak when your betters are talking. So.
Yes,
before
sir.
Before I give the score, I am afraid that I'm going to say there's another disqualifying factor, which is the Rosetta Stone thing. There's a little kitschy sort of novelty, cool thing about it and whatnot, but at the same time, I can't help but see, smell, and taste.
You gave it a five.
The tyranny of the minority here, which is the Frenchmen of Canada, which is less than like 20% or whatever, and they're forcing everybody to put their long, complicated words on all of their packages. And Steve, I can't even imagine your poor brain just scrambling, your old eyes fuzzing up looking at everything.
Didn't you highlight that as a benefit? Like, didn't you highlight that as a reason to give it a five? You gave it a five.
They reduced two words down to one. All dress is assassiné.
No, they didn't reduce
it. You referenced that as a reason you liked it.
They increased two words to three because it says all dressed and assassins. And I was talking about packaging. Now I'm talking about values. And what do I value? I value democracy. I value freedom. I value values, positive values. And I think what these folks value are just something a little bit different. And that's why I've always kind of considered Canada the upside down world sort of thing. Like everything's a little off, a little different. And Steve has become more and more untethered from what nurtured him, what created him, which is America and her values. And I want to try and bring him back to where he came from. And so he doesn't go fucking like bouncing off into space balls over there in communist Canada. And although there is some neat novelty to the French words that you can see on a bag overall, I think there's something a little bit wrong about it, something a little nasty, and something that I think we ought to maybe take a closer look at, maybe in an open forum.
Yeah.
So overall, I'm going to give this a 4 out of 5 on values.
Oh, no. Okay. That was a stunner. I was waiting for the 5.
Yeah. All right, so that means that overall, Steve gave this a 92%, Kevin a 90%, Brady a 96%, which I think you gave 100% to anyway, but 96%. David gave it an 84%, and I gave it a 94%, which overall we have a 91.28%, which puts us, what is that? That's
fourth place.
Yeah, that's a tie.
Yeah,
that's a tie for fourth. With another chip flavor, Zaps Voodoo. Very similar to the Pata snack, Matoto Artianale.
Yeah. Another international brand, yeah.
Yeah, another, yeah, wow, right. Really creeping.
And look at Sterzing still holding strong.
I was just going to say, that's our litmus test, like, it's better than Sterzing, right?
Yeah,
like,
obviously.
Might have to compare a chip.
Some other people said this, but I've almost polished the entire bag, and I feel like I could mm-hmm. win an Ironman competition or something right now.
Yeah, they're incredible.
That's a really good point. I feel the same way. You don't feel gross.
You could. I'm still eating it. Here, for it's sure. really good.
Quality lives here, David. Can you do me a favor? Thank you all so much for being here for this very short episode. I just want everybody to go to chipheads.us. Go check us out on Instagram, YouTube, and remember to keep a chip.
Don't let me down. Potato chips, how my mouth does drip. Potato chips, hold, drip, drip, drip. Crunch, crunch, I don't want no lunch. All I want is potato chips. Bang, bang, bang.